We are going to continue to learn Genesis chapter 29, verse 1 through 30. The title is Sin Will Catch Up With You, Learn in the Hard Way. 那今天我们准备学习创世纪的29章1到30节。那主题是说呢，这个罪会最终会赶上你啊，最终会给你带来这个后果的。那么另外一个呢，就是我们往往呢是通过一种非常艰难或困难的时间去学习。Sometimes we don't want to listen the teaching from our parents or from our teacher or our friend, even though we knew that is truth. 啊，有些时候呢，我们不愿意听从老师的教导啊，家长的说服啊，还有一些同学的这个劝诫，虽然道理非常明白啊，但是我们不愿意去听从。Until one day we went through the hardship ourselves, we experienced the difficulty, the consequence we have facing. 直到有一天呢，我们经过了这件事情的一个错误啊，直到有一天呢，我们经历了一些困难，才明白哦，原来父母或同学或者师长所讲的都是非常有道理的哈。So today's the title is Sin Will Catch YouUp with you, 啊，罪的最终会给你带来这个后果。And we're going to learn in the hard way, 啊，我们通常呢会通过这种困难和艰难时间来去学习的这么一个经验。So all scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, equipped for every good work.圣经都是由上帝所启示的，有于教导、督责、矫正和在义上训练，叫属上帝的人得以完全，为行各样的善事而装备。God is faithful, by whom you were called into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. 上帝是信实的，他呼召你们和与他儿子，我们的主耶稣基督共享团契。So my brother and sister, I want to remind you again, the reason you come to online or any different service to learn the Bible, it's not because somebody else, but because yourself, you know God is faithful and by whom you were called into the fellowship. And because God is faithful and He used the scripture to talk to us and He never changed and no matter what we have done. 那今天的节目想在这里再提醒你一下啊。你之所以能够参加线上的学习或者线下各种不同的圣经学习，因为要与主耶稣基督联系在一起，与我们其他的弟兄姐妹联系在一起，因为上帝是信实的，要求我们去进行聚会，而且呢，上帝是通过他的这个圣经来去教导我们的，教导我们为行各样的善事而装备的。 So the purpose of learning the BibleIt's because of God. 啊，我们是因为上帝而学习圣经的，这点不要忘记。So now please turn on your mic and follow me to read today's scripture catechisms. 啊，接下来呢，请你把这个麦风打开啊，跟我一起读一下今天的圣经教理问答。大家可以把这个麦风打开，跟我一起读一下。Should those who have faith,
in Christ,
seek their salvation. Through their own works. Or anywhere else.
No.
They should not.
As everything necessary
to salvation is found in Christ.
To seek salvation
through good works is a denial.
Is a denial.
That Christ is only Redeemer and Savior.
That Christ is Redeemer and Savior.
那今天圣经问圣经教理问答说呢，那些对基督怀有信仰的人是否应该通过自己的行为或其他地方来寻求救恩？回答说不应当，因为救恩所需的一切都在基督里，借着善行来获取救恩，就是在否认基督是唯一的救主。So my brothers and sisters, especially upon your living in China, you must hear a lot of teaching said you must do some good things in order you can receive something. 亲爱的弟兄姐妹，特别是你在我们中国啊，你经常会听说，如果你做得好的话，你会得到什么奖励，或者说你应该怎么去做好事才能会赢得一些称赞。你看看微信朋友圈里面啊，经常会有一些人啊发出一些自己所做的一些好的事情啊。这个其实也没有什么错啊，但是关键是他的一个动机是什么。在这里呢，也通常会有人把我们的基督信仰啊跟其他信仰混淆在一起，好像说你要通过啊做好事，或者通过服侍教会，或者通过一些其他方面来得到上帝的救恩。那事实上不是这样的哈，上帝的救恩给我们呢，不是因为我们做了什么好事，也不是为了让我们做什么好事才给我们救恩。上帝给了我们这个救恩、就是救赎的恩典、才拯救我们，通过耶稣基督替代我们在十字架上死亡，从而呢我们的罪得赦免，获得永生。这样一个救恩呢，是白白的给了我们、不是因为我们做了些什么事情，也不是因为我们要做什么事情，而是因为上帝本身他爱我们，他给了我们，我们因为感动而去做了其他的事情、不是因为我们做了什么事情上帝才给我们。And today the way we learn have a little different than before. 那今天我们、学习的方法呢跟过去呢稍微有一点不同啊。We're going to review the background story from today's passage. 我们将会回顾一下啊今天的故事发生之前的一些背景。And then we're going to ask you to think about yourself why this happened. 接下来呢我想让你在心里去想啊，为什么这件事情会发生啊 ？It is very important. We're going to learn the history in order we can give us the direction for our current lives. Because people said the history like the mirror, so you can see yourself. 非常重要，我们要学习历史啊。通常说，历史为鉴，历史就像一个镜子一样，照出你自己，可以知道你现在的一个行为。So today we are going to review.From Genesis chapter 28, 接下来的话呢我们来去、从创世纪的28章往前呢一起看一下到底前面发生了一个什么样的事情啊。Genesis chapter 28, verse 1 through 9, we learned the title is The Choice Matters, Jacob versus Esau. 创世纪的28章1到9节我们学习了这个雅各和以扫的故事啊，这个选择很重要。那接下来呢，我们学习的 Genesis chapter 28 verse 10 through 22 the title is I will not leave you 啊，这个主题是我不会离开你。So the story is Jacob tricked his father and got the blessing and thenHe was afraid to get killed by his brother, and his mother tried to let him to ask him from that situation and send him away. 那事实是什么呢？就是当时这个雅各呀，这个跟他妈妈一起啊，欺骗了他的父亲啊，得到了本来其实是属于自己的祝福，用自己的人的手段呢，获取这样一个祝福。然后呢，他哥哥呢就非常生气啊，扬言要准备杀了他，说他妈妈为了保护他呢。就把他派走了到他舅舅家里面那边家里到他舅舅家里去了哈。So today we are going to learn what happened after that. 今天我们准备学习这个他这个路上啊走了一路之后啊前面我们学习的人做了一个梦。那么他现在快到了发生什么事情啊就在井边啊看见这 Rachel 这一部分啊。但是呢我们还是先 将我们的心安静下来呢，把我们这个祷告啊交给上帝，求上帝呢能够给我们怜悯，原谅我们过去一周所做的错事，还有我们心中产生各种意念，然后呢让他的圣灵带领我们今天学习。So the coming timing, let us to give a prayer to our Lord first, and ask His forgiveness and mercy, and let His Holy Spirit to be with us today as well. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, and thank you for your mercy to forgive us. Regardless of what we have done wrong, but you are maintained faithful. And let your Holy Spirit lead us for today's study. Let us to see clearly the consequence we have sinned against you, and let us to follow your instruction for your will, but not ours. I pray with your Son, Jesus' name. Amen. Today's scripture reading comes from Numbers chapter 32, verse 20 through 23, especially verse 23. 今天的这个经文阅读啊，是来自于这个民数记的32章20到23节，特别是23节啊。So let Teresa to follow me to read. 那 Teresa 跟我一起读一下啊，大家特别注意第23节。So Moses said to them, Moses said to them,
If you will take up arms, Arms.
不是 M, R, A, R, E, 发 R, 叫 Arms. To go. Before the Lord. For the war. And every armed man of you will pass over the Jordan before the Lord, until he has driven out
his enemies
from before him, and the land is subdued
before the Lord.
Then, after that,
you shall return
and be free
of obligation.
啊，对于长的单词呢，有些时候你们可能的发音呢不一定发得出来哈，就是读得很慢。那我们怎么看呢？比如这个 obligation 这个词呢，我们分三部分来去读啊。你看 obligation， 那 obligation， 来，我们重新读一下啊 obligation.
对，obligation.
对，那以后你们遇到长的单词的时候呢，不要强迫自己读的，也读不清楚，也很难读，你也很不容易去记。那你怎么记呢？就把它分成几部分，像这个根据它的音标啊 ，obligation，obligation，obligation。那你三段分别读清楚之后呢，你再重新连读呢，就比较好读啊。Obligation to the Lord.
To the Lord.
And to Israel.
To Israel.
And this land shall be your possession. 那这个词也是个长的哈，我们来也把它分三部分来读。看 ，pro 就是 po 是一部分 ，possession，s-s-e-s-s-i-o-n，session 那个发有四个 s， 其实它就分两个 s 来去发音的。你看 ，po 是一个 possession，s-e 发了音 ，ssion 发了音，你看。Procession 啊，你再跟我读一下。Procession.
Procession.
Before the Lord.
Procession.
Before the Lord.
Before the Lord.
啊，对了，你看那个 before 啊，那个 B-B-E before the Lord。我们接着读啊，最后一节经文，我们特别大家一起注意了哈。But if you will not do so,
if no
啊，对不起，我读慢一点啊。If you will not do so, behold,
you have sinned
against the Lord, and be sure your sin
will find you
out.
Will find you out.
不是要是 Y 打头的 ，will W 打头 will。等一下，我们重新来过哈。Your sin will find you out。这个 you 怎么发音呢 ？you 呢？就是两个把舌头伸开了在嘴里面哈，然后把这个嘴啊挤在一起发这个音的哈，叫 you、哦、我给你看一下啊
，you
啊，对了啊，非常正确，对啊，这我们重新读一下啊 ，your sin will
find you
out.
You out.
非常好啊 ，Thank you. Numbers， 民数记的32:20-23呢，他是这样说的哈。摩西呢就对他们说：“你们若这样行，在耶和华面前带着兵器去打仗， 所有带兵器的人都要在耶和华面前过约旦河，等他赶出他的仇敌，那地被耶和华制服了，然后你们可以回来，向耶和华和以色列才为无罪，这地也必在耶和华面前归你们为业。第三二十三节这里哈、就特别重要，我刚才讲哈、也是我们中间今天的一个核心经节，倘若你们不这样行，就得罪耶和华，要知道你们的罪必追上你们。 So my brothers and sisters, we said Jesus died on the cross and his blood washed away our sin, but the sin has consequence. So don't think you can sin later on upon you call the Lord's name, you're going to be saved and immediately nothing happened.啊，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，如果是你信耶稣而且成为基督徒一段时间的话，你一定听说了耶稣基督的宝血洗净了我们的罪，但你要注意，他洗净了我们的罪是上帝在审判日那一天呢，不再按我们的罪来审判我们，但是我们活着的时候要为我们的罪啊负责任，而且呢会有后果，也就是在民数记的三十二章二十三节这节经文，我说这是我们今天核心的一节经文说的一样，你的罪会赶上你，啥意思呢？就你所做的一些事情都会产生一些后果，而这个后果最终呢都会显现出来啊。无论是你以前不信主，现在信了主啊，你说我以前不信主，我做了一些错事，我信了主之后是不是不再去承担我以前不信主所做的错事的后果了呢？不是这样的，你信了主之后呢，上帝原谅了你，在审判日之后时候不再按你的罪来去审判你，但是你之前所犯的罪还是会影响到你现在的生活啊。不管以前你是不对，现在做正确了，好像说哎，我以前不信上帝，现在信了上帝，是不是不应该去承担这个结果了？不是这样的。 So the consequence of your sin going to find you out、就是你这个以前做错的事情啊，结果啊，最后啊，都会给你产生一个后果。So today we review Genesis 25 and 25, 26, 27, and 29. 我们今天准备从这个创世纪的第二十五节开始啊，第二十五章开始看一看以前所学的一个内容。Like I said, why are we going to review what happened the episode before today's study? 为什么我们今天要从这么远的地方开始复习一下以前发生了什么事情呢？ Because today, the passage and whatever happened, the story, it deeply rooted what happened before.因为今天这个发生的故事还有我们要学习的一个内容呢，非常深的扎根在过去的所发生的一些事情上啊。First, let's look at Genesis chapter 25, verse 29 through 34. 首先我们看一下创世纪的第25章29到34节。The title we learned, Esau and the Red Stew.我们当时学习的是这个以扫和一碗红汤。Genesis chapter 25, verse 30 through 31.And Esau said to Jacob, Let me eat some of that red stew, for I am exhausted. Therefore his name was called Edom. Jacob said, Sell me your birthright now. 那以扫对雅各说，我疲乏得很，求你把这红汤给我喝。因此以扫又叫以东。雅各说，你今日把长子的名分卖给我吧。So look at this passage. Jacob want to exchange the birthright with one red stew. 你看看这些经文啊，这个雅各跟他哥哥打交道的时候就成人之危啊，就是说你累的时候你我给你碗红糖，你把长子的名分卖给我吧。那最后什么结果呢？ Genesis chapter 25 verse 34. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and a little stew and he ateAnd drank, and rose, and went his way. Thus, Esau despised his birthright. 于是呢，雅各呢就将饼和红汤啊给了以扫，以扫吃了喝了， 啊，便起身走了。这就是以扫轻看了他长子的名分。So during this passage, we focus Esau dispatched his birthright. 啊，在我们教导这一节经文的时候呢，我们重点集中在以扫呢看清了他的长子的名分。But today, we want to refocus on Jacob. 啊，今天呢，我们准备重新再看一看当时的情景呢，雅各是什么样的。So Jacob knew the opportunity is coming, and he grabs it. 啊，这个雅各呀，一看机会来了，他是抓住这个机会。我们讲啊，不要乘人之危啊，却要雪中送炭啊。但是现在呢，锦上添花的很多，雪中送炭的很少。乘人之危的呢，大有人在。So when you feel like you need help, but in fact, not too many people are going to help you. The only people want to give you more if you have said something. And it's very difficult, somebody going to give you with the warm, even the snow coming. But a lot of people are going to come to you if you have said a lot of stuff at will. So in this life,We saw too many episodes happen like this. 啊，我们在这个现实生活中啊，看到乘人之危的，像雅各这种人呢、啊，很多啊。但雅各的这个个性，告诉我们呢，他是一个愿意抓住机会啊，抓住一切机会为自己有利的事情。然后呢，我们记得这一点哈、啊，在他和他舅舅打交道的过程中，他又得到了什么？等我们学习经文的时候，我们再看哈、啊。So let's remember what happened between Jacob and Esau, and then.We're going to read what happened today, what happened to Jacob from his uncle Laban. So let's go to Genesis chapter 17, verse 1 through 17. 我们再回顾一下创世纪的27章1到17节。The title we learned at that time is Man's Deceitful Thought. 在那个时候呢，我们学习的是在当时我们的学习经文的主题呢是人类这个欺骗的思想。Genesis chapter 27 verse 1 through 4 When Isaac was told and his eyes were dim so that he couldn't see, he called Esau his older son and said to him, My son, and he answered, Here I am. He said, Behold, I am old. I don't know the day of my death.Now then, take your weapons, your quivers, and your bow, and go out to the field and hunt game for me. And prepare for me delicious food, such as I love, and bring it to me, so that I may eat, that my soul may bless you before I die. 创世纪的27章1到4节，当时我们学习到以撒年老的时候，凭着自己的心意，他觉得自己眼睛看不见，在这个世上时日无多，就叫了他大儿子以扫去打猎，拿给他吃，然后呢，他好在他临死之前给他祝福。然后呢，当时呢，这个利百加听说了，他就告诉了雅各，我们才知道后来雅各欺骗了他的父亲哈。So Genesis chapter 27 verse 11 through 12.But Jacob said to Rebekah, his mother, Behold, my brother Esau is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. Perhaps my father will fail me, and I shall seem to be mocking him, and bring a curse upon myself, and not a blessing. 当时我们学这些经文的时候特别提到了，雅各对他母亲利百加说他不愿意去欺骗他父亲的理由呢，不是因为这件事情不对，而是因为他怕遭诅咒。不是得到了祝福啊。So we can see the character of Jacob. He wants to do something, but he is afraid the consequence from the Lord, but not from the stuff is right or wrong. 你看雅各啊，他在这节经文里可以看得出他的一个性格哈。他害怕一些事情，不说这个事对与错，害怕他的上帝啊会惩罚他，他会遭诅咒啊。That's why he dreamed the Lord before he went to his uncle's house. 这就是我们上礼拜所学习的哈。他去他舅舅家之前，在路上他做了一个梦啊，因为他很敬畏上帝啊。So let's ask to review Genesis chapter 27, verse 18 through 29, and the title we learn at the moment is God's sovereignty willing despite human imperfection. 啊，我们再看一下创世纪的27:18-29，当时我们学习的主题呢是上帝的主权意愿啊，无论可能人类不完美啊，上帝的主权意愿呢还是不容改变的。Matthew chapter 6 verse 8 Do not be like them, for your father knows what you need before you ask him. 啊，让我们不要像外邦人一样，在我们祈求之前，你们的父呢就已经知道你们的需求了。So God has complete sovereignty over all things. 啊，上帝对所有的一切，在一切之上，他有一个至高无上的主权。And we learned God's purpose stands firm, demonstrating His sovereignty over our actions. 啊，上帝的意志呢，坚定不移，显示出他对我们行为的一个主权哈。And we learn from Romans chapter 9, verse 15 through 16, For he said to Moses, I will have mercy on whom I have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I have compassion. So then it depends not on human will or exertion, but on God who has mercy. 啊，当时我们学习罗马书9:15-16，这个上帝啊跟摩西说的，我要怜悯谁就怜悯谁，我要恩待谁就恩待谁。可见呢，上帝的恩典和怜悯呢，不在于人的意志和努力，而在于他的怜悯啊。So let's go to Genesis chapter 29, verse. Let's go to Genesis chapter 27, verse 41 through 46. The title we learn is "Sin Tears Family Apart." 那接下来呢，我们就看看创世纪的27:41-46呢，我们学习了罪呀、使家庭的分裂啊。Genesis chapter 27, verse 42 through 45. But the words of Esau, her old son, were told to Rebekah. So he sent and called Jacob, her younger son, and said to him, Behold, your brother Esau comforted himself about you by planning to kill you. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice, arise, flee to Laban, my brother in Haran, and stay with him a while, until your brother's fury turns away, until your brother's anger turns away from you, and he forgets what you have done to him. Then I will send and bring you from there. Why should I be bereft of you both in one way?在创世纪的27:42-44，我们看到作为母亲的利百加听说大儿子要杀他的小儿子的时候，他对他小儿子说了什么话？他对他小儿子说，你起来要逃到我哥哥那里去啊，等到你哥哥消了气，忘了你对他所做的事情，我再把你接回来。 So my brother says, Is somebody going to forgive or forget what you have done to them? No, never.They always remember what they have done wrong, but it's easy to forget what they have did right. 啊，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你想想你身边的人们是不是很容易忘了你做错了一些事情呢？是不是很容易就原谅了你呢？还是他们总是记着你的错？比如说你父母、你的兄长、你的朋友，总是提起你曾经做错的事情。人一旦给人加了一个标签，是很难去去除的。在这里，利百加说，等他的哥哥忘了这件事情。以扫给了祝福给雅各，以扫怀恨在心，这么大一件事情怎么会轻易的就忘记了呢？所以本身他这个教导就有了问题啊。然后呢，这个利百加当然也面临着这样一个后果，就是他儿子一下走了20年就没再见着他了哈。 Then fast forwarding, we come to Genesis chapter 28, verse 1 through 9. The title is Choice Matter we reviewed earlier. 那接着我们就看到了创世纪的28:1-9啊，我们前面复习过，这个主题是选择很重要啊。然后我们在这个创世纪的28:1-5是这样说的哈。Then Isaac called Jacob and blessed him and directed him.You must not take a wife from the Canaanite woman. Arise, go to Paddan Aram, to the house of Bethuel, your mother's father, and take as your wife from there one of the daughters of Laban, your mother's brother. God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and multiply you, that you may become a company peoples. May he give the blessing of Abraham to you and to your offspring with you, that you may take possession of the land of your sojourns that God gave to Abraham. Thus Isaac sent Jacob away, and he went to Paddan Aram to Laban, the son of Bethuel, the Aramean, the brother of Rebekah, Jacob's and Esau's mother. 在创世纪二十八章一到九节，以撒就听了他妻子的话，叫了雅各来给他祝福。当然，这个祝福我们也非常熟悉，是给了亚伯拉罕的祝福啊。然后重复一下，给了雅各说：“上帝会赐福给你。现在的你到你那个母舅家里啊，娶一个媳妇啊。”这是他给这个雅各所说的话。那今天本来我们想听一首歌曲啊，我想应该时间不够了。这个歌曲名字叫《By Faith》，因着信哈。为什么在这里要插播一个这个敬拜歌曲 By Faith 呢？ Because Jacob went away from his family is because of faith. 因为呢，雅各呀，他离开了家，去了舅舅家，就是因为他的信心，他相信了上帝的祝福，他相信了他父亲给他说的话，他对上帝有信心，所以他才走的哈。那但我们今天不再听了哈。Then let's officially look today's passage.We only left 60 minutes, but we're going to go over this quickly. Genesis chapter 29, verse 1 through 30. The title is Sin Will Catch You Up With You. Learn in the Hard Way. 那今天呢，我们学习的经文呢是创世纪的29章1到30节。啊，我们只有这个15分钟时间呢，我们很快就过一下啊。主题呢说罪呀、啊。会赶上你，而且呢，我们是用一种非常困难、艰难的方法来去学习。I reveal in most of time what happened before today's episode. I want to tell you what you have done in the past, whatever the history going to reflect your today's life. 啊，我用了大部分的时间今天来回顾一下雅各到了他舅舅家里面遇见 Richard 的故事啊，在。为什么花了这么长时间来去讲他的过去呢？我们今天花了将近三分之二的时间来去讲啊，现在只剩十五分钟时间来去看今天的故事。为什么？因为历史是如此的重要，我们过去所做的事情就直接影响了我们今天的生活。If we did not understand the history, we're not going to understand right now the current society. 如果我们不理解历史啊，我们很难理解现实，也很难理解现在发生了一个什么样的事情。 So let's review today's passage together and keep in mind what happened before. 那让我们一起来去、学习一下今天的经文啊，在你脑海里要记着、啊、我刚才跟你讲的之前发生了一个什么事情啊。雅各欺骗了他的哥哥，拿到了这个 birthright， 欺骗了他的父亲，拿到了一个祝福。在雅各眼里呢，在他妈妈眼里呢，他们通过欺骗的手段拿到，当然是不光彩的，他内心应该也不平安的。其实我们知道，根据这个圣经的教导呢，这些都是本应该给他的。说人心的诡诈，自以为得计，其实还是回到了上帝的一个意愿之中。但是他这样对了别人呢，上帝没有跟雅各说你这样做不对，然后呢你要改正，上帝却教雅各用另外一种方法教了雅各哈。God teach Jacob in a different way, as same as God teach us at will. 就像上帝教我们也是一样，他可能不一定像我们父母一样跟你说，你这个事情做的不对，你这个事情做的对，你应该怎样去做。但上帝告诉你什么是对的，也告诉你什么是不应该做。但你一定要做呢，上帝也没有特别的阻拦你啊。最终呢，你会用一种非常痛苦、艰难的方法来学习的你的教训。Now, let's ask to see how God teach Jacob his lessons. 啊，你看这个雅各自以为得计啊，欺骗了他哥哥，欺骗了他父亲，又逃跑了啊，这个内心的不平安呢。但是上帝是如何教雅各他的不对，还有他的一个教训呢？我们今天就看这个创世纪的二十九章一到三十节啊。Genesis chapter 29, verse 1 through 30, we have four different sections. Number one, the faithful encounter, verses 1 through 14. Number two, the willing of sacrifice for love, verses 15 through 20. Number 3, the truth is truth, verses 21 through 25. Number 4, the deceiver, confrontation with deceiver, verses 26 through 30. 我们今天呢准备分四部分来去回顾复习一下这个创世纪的29章1到30节。第一个呢就是命运的转折点啊，创世纪29章1到14节。第二个呢就是为爱愿意牺牲，这是15到20节。第三个呢事实就是事实，21到25节。第四个就是欺骗者遇到欺骗者啊。So if you look at this carefully, something is wrong here. And this which I prepared earlier. 但你看我这一张 PPT 的时候啊，你看是有些地方是不对的哈。Genesis chapter 29 verse 1 through 30, but I put 3. 那这应该是二创世纪二十九章一到三十节，我却呢做了三，没有打十，然后呢。我就把每一份都做成了三而不是三十。So I found out earlier. 这个我们看一下啊，应该是创世纪二十九章一到三十节。Why I mention this? 啊，我这你们刚才不知道有没有发现这个错误啊？我是在准备这个讲章的时候啊，发现这个错误的。创世纪二十九章一到三十节，我却写成了创世纪二十九章一到三，那个十没有打上去。接下来我分了四点，然后呢把四点copy 复制啊，粘贴啊，四点全是错误的。So my brother sisters, if you did something wrong, if you did not make a correction, you're going to be like me, copy all the time in your life. 这弟兄姐妹，我想再强调一下啊，如果你做错了一些事情，和你如果不悔改、不改正的话，在你的生命中啊，你就像我刚才这个 PPT 一样，它会一直的复制粘贴、复制粘贴，在你身上打上烙印。好像你一直都没有做对一样，因为什么呢？因为你没有改正。耶稣说的，天国近了要悔改。The Jesus told us, the kingdom of God is near, repent. 就这个意思啊。Let's look at Genesis chapter 29, verse 1 through 14, the fateful encounter. 啊，我们看一下创世纪二十九章一到十四节发生这个故事呢，就是命运转折点的一个遭遇啊。Genesis chapter 29, verse 1 through 14. We only look at verse 1, and I'm going to give you a summary, the rest of the verses. 啊，我们只是读一下这一节经文啊，然后我把这个其他几节经文呢，就总结一下。Then Jacob went on his journey and came to the land of the people of the east. 然后呢，这个雅各呀，就继续他的前行啊，然后来到了这个东边的这个人的居住地哈。So then, 啊，然后 from when, 啊，从哪里开始呢？ From his dreaming, 啊，我们上里面学习了雅各梦见了上帝的梯子，然后呢，从那里以后他继续前行。So we learned last week, Jacob dreamed the light of the Lord, and then from that time, he went on.When he arrived the well in Haran, he encountered shepherds willing to water their flocks. Jacob inquired about Laban, his mother's brother, and the shepherds confirmed his relationship to Laban. As the conversation going on, Rachel, Laban's daughter, approached with her father's sheep. 我们接下来这个经文呢，大体是这样说的哈，当这个雅各到了之后啊，看了一口井，然后呢，井旁边就有牧羊人，他就问呢，哎，你们认识不认识拉班呢？你看这个，去了就问人家啊，你说，哎，对呀，这是拉班的羊。正说的时候呢，这个 Rachel 啊，就是他的这个未来的妻子啊，就走过来了。然后发生一个什么事情呢？在第九节我们来看一下 ，While he was still speaking with them, Rachel came with her father's sheep, for she was a Shepherds 啊，当这个雅各跟这些牧羊人正在说的时候啊，这个 Rachel 就带着他父亲的羊啊来了。你看啊，在这个时候雅各看见了 ，So Jacob moved by her beauty and cousinship, rolled the stone from the well and watered Laban's flock overwhelmed with emotion, he kissed Rachel and wept. The passage marks the meeting of Jacob and Rachel, the first time the event integrated to the biblical narrative. It told us God's plan through family connection and providence. 在这一节经文里啊，我们看到啊，上帝有他的计划，他通过家族的一些关系啊，像这个雅各和 Rachel 啊，来去进行他的计划。而这个雅各看了 Rachel 呢，他马上献殷勤的把这个石头挪开了，给他的羊去喝水啊。他看见的不只是 Rachel 的美丽，因为当时你想一想，这个特别在过去那个年代啊，犹太的女的都是穿了一个黑袍子，这就是那个一双眼睛，他怎么看她美丽呢？要看她的眼睛。他觉得这个 Rachel 很漂亮啊，他不仅仅看她的一个容貌，而且看她有羊，说明这个雅各呀非常势利啊。你看他人又漂亮又有羊，所以他决定啊马上献了殷勤啊。你可以具体读一下这些经文。So let's look at Genesis chapter 29, verse 15 through 20. We only focus three verses. Then Laban said to Jacob, "Because you are my kinsman, should you therefore serve me for nothing? Tell me, what shall your wages be?" Now Laban had two daughters. The name of the older was Liz, and the name of the younger was Rachel. Liz's eye was weak, but Rachel was beautiful in form and appearance. 当时那个拉班呢，就跟雅各说的啊，你是我家族的人呐、啊，那你给我工作了这一个月，你要什么样的工资啊？你尽管开口提就可以了。那当时呢，这个雅各就看他两个女儿啊，这个姐姐呢眼睛呢比较弱一点，其实呢就刚才我讲的啊，过去这一个犹太人的女孩子啊，穿都是一些长袍子，啥也看不见，就看一双眼，看那个眼睛呢，可能那个 Rachel 比她姐姐长得漂亮，所以说她就比较喜欢这个 Rachel 啊。 So deeply in love with Rachel and proposed to work for 7 years in exchange for her in marriage 啊，因为当时她去了之后，刚才讲她啥也没带嘛，连水啊这个就快没有了，衣服啊食物啊，当时她在做梦的时候还求上帝给她水和衣物，就这么一个穷小子来到她舅舅家里面，他想跟他舅舅的女儿结婚，要给他聘礼呀、啊。他没有聘礼怎么办呢？所以他就是给这个舅舅说呀、啊：“我替你工作7年啊，我把这个我应该得的东西啊，作为聘礼来娶你的女儿，做一个交换啊。” So Genesis chapter 29, verse 15 through 20, and look at what Laban said. In verse 19, 在第十九节呢，在拉班就这样说的哈 ：“It is better.” 最好 that I gave her to you than that I shall give her to any other man. Stay with me. 你看他舅舅啊，好像是特别亲热，而且把他当成自己人一样，说哎呀，与其我把我女儿许配给别人的，不如许配给你好了，对吧？你就跟我在一起吧。 So Laban agreed this arrangement. Seems like it's fair, but it's not. 他舅舅呢就看着这个机会啊，就雅各应该是爱上他的女儿了，他抓着这个机会呢，就希望呢雅各能够替他工作。Look at what Laban did to Jacob 啊，你看看这个拉班呢对这个他的外甥啊，这一个叫什么这个雅各呀、啊，他所做的事情。It's very similar what Jacob did to Esau 啊，跟这个雅各对他哥哥所做的事情非常的相似啊，大家都是抓住了机会。当以扫很累的时候，雅各抓住机会，用一碗红汤就换取了以扫的长子的名分。当雅各爱上了这个 Rachel， 他的舅舅抓住机会就让他给他工作了7年，而且还不止这样一件事情啊，我们后面再来看啊。 Genesis chapter 29Verse 21 through 25. The appointed time arrived, and Jacob approached Laban to claim his bride, Rachel. Laban, however, instead of presenting Rachel to Jacob on the wedding, Laban gave him his elder daughter Liz. 你看到这个时间到了、啊、雅各说的，舅舅，我现在要需要跟这个Rachel 结婚了。拉班怎么样呢？也欺骗了他，用他的姐姐代替了他的妹妹。 is what he had done, similar like Jacob did his father. 啊，这个你和这个雅各欺骗了他父亲这一点呢也差不多少。雅各用这个抓住机会得到了他哥哥的长子的名分，那拉班抓住机会让雅各为他工作了七年。雅各欺骗了他父亲获得了祝福，而拉班呢也欺骗了雅各，把他的长女嫁给了雅各。再看22节和25节两节经文哈。So Laban gathered together all the people of the place and made a feast. 25节啊。And in the morning, behold, it was Liz. And Jacob said to Laban, What is this you have done to me? Did I not serve you for Rachel? Why then have you deceived me? 啊，你看这个清早起来之后，啊，雅各发现原来不是 Rachel， 却是他的姐姐，他就质问了他舅舅哈。刚才说了，为什么他没有发现头天晚上啊？但你看在22节说过啊，他们有一个酒会啊，一个宴会，我想应该是雅各喝多了哈。So Genesis chapter 21 through 25 told us Laban did exactly what Jacob did to his family. 啊，在这一段经文呢，我们看到这个拉班呢，用同样欺骗的手段抓住机会啊，对待这个雅各，正像雅各抓住机会欺骗了他父亲和对他哥哥一样。英语有一句话叫说 "Whatever goes around, come around." 啊。那中文也有一句话叫种瓜得瓜，种豆得豆啊。你过去你怎么对别人呢，到最后呢你可能经历了同样的事情。为什么你会经历同样的事情？因为上帝要让你知道你如何对别人，别人是如何感受的，就让你感同身受。为什么让你感同身受？就希望你能够去悔改啊。So Genesis chapter 29 verse 26 through 30, the last point we're going to learn today is the deceiver confrontation with deceiver. 啊，你看欺骗者遇到欺骗者啊。Genesis chapter 29 verse 26, Laban said, It is not so done in our country to give the younger before the firstborn. 他就给自己啊，给雅各一个借口啊，姐姐都没结婚，妹妹不能结先结啊，所以说呢你再给我工作吧，然后我就把妹妹一起许给你啊。And Jacob agreed, and 雅各呢就同意了他的舅舅的一个提议啊。我们看最后一节经文。So Jacob went in to Rachel also, and he loved Rachel more less, and served Laban for another 7 years. 然后呢这个雅各也就跟 Rachel 他所爱的女人呢就结了婚，然后又工作了七年。但是呢他更爱这样一个 Rachel 而不是他姐姐。结果后面又发生什么事情呢？ Because the love to Rachel more than Liz, that's create a lot of chaos to Jacob's life. 啊，因为他爱这个 Rachel 的姐姐，因为他爱 Rachel 比更爱他姐姐呢，导致于他的生活呀发生了更多的一些问题啊。我们下礼拜再学习啊。So today's conclusion 啊，今天的经文，今天我们学习经文的一个结论呢，就是 our actions.Especially those rooted in deceit will ultimately be unveiled. 就我们的行为啊，特别那些根植于欺骗的行为，就是我们通过欺骗手段得到今天的一个行为，最终都会被揭露出来啊。中国有一句话非常简单，叫纸包不住火啊。Application 啊，今天的应用呢也是非常简单，就一句话 ：Find redemption and restoration even.In the midst of wrestling with deception. 啊，即使我们现在与自己的个性的软弱或在欺骗中的这个博弈的过程中啊，也能找到救赎和再造。That's the only way you can be saved is repent. 那我们能够被拯救的唯一的一点呢，就是我们需要悔改。啊，让我们为今天的学习来做个祷告。亲爱的天父上帝，我们感谢你的带领，也愿你赐福给我们每一位尊道教会的弟兄姐妹。为那些没有来参加教会聚会的姐妹来祷告，希望他们在新的一年里面能够有着你的祝福，愿他们能够找到一个时间啊，坚持学习你的话语，因为你是使我们能够行善，你的话语带有力量。特别为那些今天能够参加聚会的弟兄姐妹祷告，也要你赐福给他们，因为他们 知道自己应该做什么，因为他们知道他要听出你的话语，因为他们知道圣灵会带领我们。也感谢你通过今天的经文告诉我们，无论我们过去做错了一些什么事情，都会有一些后果。你已经原谅了我们罪，在未来审判不再审判，按照我们的罪来审判我们，但是我们要去面对自己过去的罪所带来的今天的后果。请你让我们有一颗悔改的心，也愿你加添我们的力量，求你赐福给我们，给我们展现我们脚前的路，不要让我们再走弯路。以上祷告奉我主基督耶稣的名求， Amen。 May God bless you. See you tomorrow or next week. 愿上帝赐福给你，我们明天或下礼拜再见。